What's up, YouTube? Capital G here. Got a DDD duel showing off the new length monster and how just resilient DDD as an archetype can be. Even when they get their fill blown up, it doesn't even matter. They can just summon everything back. I'm talking about being able to summon a field of like five monsters back during your opponent's turn. It's actually pretty damn incredible. Everybody was just kind of shitting on the new DDD monster, but the fact that it lets you complete a full pendulum scale is really good. And DDD have so many monster reborns. Like, I know that King Ragnarok has two monster reborns built into him. This guy right here, he has a monster reborn when he's summoned, and then he has a monster reborn in his pendulum scale effect. And, you know, Genghis has the same thing. So you guys are going to see exactly what I'm talking about. And he's still able to make a turn one field with a level of negation too, which is pretty good. So he's going to go for Genghis. That's one of your monster reborns. Night Howling is another monster reborn built into it. He's going to go for Gilgamesh, set those pendulum scales up. And I believe he's going to summon Ragnarok off of Green Slime. He activates the pendulum scale effect and the Ragnarok effect, and now he's able to go into some nice Xyz monsters. And this is a pretty good turn one board, if I don't say so myself, because not only, well, he doesn't have full pendulum scales, but he has full protection for just about all his DDD monsters. Now, if they're banished from something like Evenly Match, okay, you just got to live with that. But DDD Wave King Caesar allows you to basically get back your monsters if they're destroyed. So, you know, at the end of the battle phase, you kind of just get the cards back like they're nothing. And then this guy right here, the Executive, or the King Executive Caesar, this card has built-in negation. When your opponent activates a card that tries to, like, special summon a monster, then you can actually negate that. And you get 1,800 attack on another DDD monster that you control, so your monsters get even more difficult to kill. And I did not realize this, Ragnarok's pendulum effect activates during both players' turns, or it can activate during both players' turns, so you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. So he's going to activate Caesar's effect. This means that, again, if any of his DDD monsters are destroyed, he can just get them back at the end of the battle phase. Has to pay some life points, but, you know, it's an optional effect. I believe. He's going to activate Brilliant Fusion. That's going to be negated. His monster is going to gain 1,800 attack. Then he's going to go for Poly. That's going to be negated too. His other monster is going to gain 1,800 attack. He gets the final Poly off, and Fright for Tiger is going to activate. And you would think that killing three monsters in a turn would actually be beneficial, but it's really not. So he loses all three monsters. Two of them are just going to float into DDD spells, or, you know, DDD spells, so it's really not going to be that big of a difference. But then we know that if you kill the DDD link monster, it just replaces itself with another monster from the extra deck. So check this out. So he's going to get his Executive Alexander, and since he did special summon a DDD monster, this Ragnarok is going to be able to activate, and then it's going to be kind of like chain summoning, because when Ragnarok activates the special summon, then this guy's effect is going to activate, and he's going to say, wait, you special summoned? I'm going to activate a monster reborn because you did that. So look how many monsters he's able to get back. Whoops, I was supposed to hit play there. Because DDD have so many monster reborns, there's one, now the synchro monster is going to activate, Ragnarok's going to activate, and look at this, he's rebuilding his entire board. It's like his tiger did absolutely nothing, and then he can't even kill the Genghis because the original Caesar's effect activates. Even though he attacked into Genghis, Caesar brings it back during the end of the battle phase. So basically he blew up three monsters but accomplished absolutely nothing. In fact, I think his field's even stronger now than when he started. And man, I was supposed to hit play again. I'm trolling. There we go. You can see right now his opponent has nothing on field but a Fright for Tiger, and there are just so many monsters that are bigger than that. Especially, I mean, his synchro was 6,000 attack. I probably just would have left it on the field, but guess he wanted to go for some style points there. So DDD can still do some really cool plays. I think that people are just a little stuck in their ways, and they're like, ah, there's only one way to play DDD, and this is the only way to play it. When no, there's a lot of ways to play DDD, and unless you get like Evenly Matched or your monsters get tributed by Raw Spear Mode, if they just get destroyed, they will come back if you make these type of turn one board. So I'm gonna pause for one hot second. I'm gonna show you guys what the deck looks like. Okay, so this is what the DDD deck looks like on paper, and as you guys saw in the duel, no Crystal Wing, no Omega, no problem. In fact, this guy does not have a single card in his extra deck that is not a DDD monster, with the only exception being Crystron Needle Fiber. So obviously he's saying, look, we can just stay within the archetype. There are many cards in this archetype that do have disruption. I know the High King Genghis is the card that just got released in Soul Fusion. This card can negate a Speller Trap, so that's pretty cool. You obviously have Siegfried, who does the same exact thing. And then you guys saw this one right here, the High King Executive Caesar, which is basically this guy, but a little bit beefier. He can negate a couple of cards and pump your monsters up at the same time. And because there's so many different monster reborns in this archetype, you can really get rocking and rolling, and you can summon a bunch of monsters, not just during your turn, but obviously during your opponent's turn as well. No traps in this deck, so obviously he's banking on the early game. And from what I've seen, usually that's kind of how DDDs roll. But, you know, I think the Link Monster, people just have to give it a little time, experiment with DDDs more, and you'll find out it's a perfectly fine card for the archetype.